Good morning and a heartfelt welcome this morning to our Sunday morning service live here on Facebook, the online church. And today we are going to have communion as well. So if you want to partake of the Holy Communion, the Lord's Supper, as some might know it, please get your elements ready, your grape juice and your bread, and you can take part in the communion with us. Now today I'm Stanley. We are broadcasting from Brits Northwestern Province in South Africa from Henry and Michelle's house here on the farm. Hallelujah. It's such a privilege. While we are sitting here, you just hear the ducks and the morning early, the rooster crowed and woke us up. We were already awake,
yes,
but he just made sure you are really awake. So praise the Lord. Yes, I'm Stanley. I'm going to minister in English today, and my wife will be ministering Afrikaans, and she is.
Karen, goeiemorgen. Baie welkom hier by ons vanoggend. En wat 'n voorreg om net weer die woord van die Here te mag bedien vanoggend. Dit is net so amazing om dit te doen en deel daarvan te wees. En ek denk vir elkeen is dit 'n geweldige voorreg om die woord van die Here aan mense te mag bedien, om siele te red, te verlos, vry te maak, want dit is die krag van God tot redding, dis sy woord.
Amen.
En volgende werk het weer so in my hart om te denk, joh Here, dit is wat u vir ons gegee het, nagelaat het, en dit is wat ons kan gebruik om vir mekaar te bemoedig, te stig, op te bou, toe te rus vir ons dienswerk, loof die Here. En wees volgende deel, deel het daar na jou tydlijn toe, na jou status toe, dat allemaal het kan sien. Dit is my so oulik gewees, so my het met ons getuig, en sy sê, sy sit altyd mos haar goed op haar status, die link van die boodskap en so aan, en enig toe vergeet sy om dit te doen, en iemand kontak haar wat altyd het kyk, en sê, hoor jy so, hoe kom jy nie vandag dit op jou status gesit? So mense kyk, hulle raak bewus daarvan, baie keer dink ons doen dit verniet, maar mense kyk daarna, hulle weet,
yes,
dit is waarby jy besig is, dis wat jy doen,
amen.
So ons is net opgewonde, en ek en my man gepraat gister, so kyk, ons het 'n vreeslose bediening, en dit is net so amazing, dat ons nie hoef te vrees vir enige mens, vir enige iets, ons kan die evangelie en die vryheid en lewe en liefde bedien. Kyk, as ek hoor hoe mense die evangelie bedien, dan denk ek, joh Here, die mense is werklik vreesloos.
Yes.
So ja, dit is vir ons een riem onder die hart, en geniet vir oggend die boodskap, en ons gaan nagmaal hou. Eerste, kry jou goedjies gereed, so dat jy saam met ons kan nagmaal hou.
Yes, good morning. As we are giving the opportunity for everybody to tune in live, do share the message there to your Facebook timeline, to your WhatsApp status. And one of the young girls, she forgot to share the message to her status, the link. And afterwards, some friend asked her, why didn't you do it? Why didn't you share it this time? So people are looking at your status, they get used to it, and maybe they can become curious enough, maybe just to listen to the one message or the second message, and so the Lord can touch them and save their souls if they're not saved, encourage them and deliver them if they are saved from other things, and also that the Lord can help us to overcome our ignorance, because I think that is the biggest problem and struggle for a child of God, a born-again Christian, sometimes is ignorance. And when we have real questions, that it is as if it's keeping our spiritual growth back.
That's right.
And when you receive that answer and you understand something from the Word of God, it just breaks through and your spiritual walk continues and you start to grow spiritually. Hallelujah. Isn't that amazing? So you can contribute to a soul that can be saved, as well as a child of God, a brother and sister in Christ that can be encouraged and can come to the knowledge of the truth of God's word. Because there's so many gospels going out every day on social media, every Sunday, it's not even Sundays anymore. And we must not be shy for this ministering of truth,
amen,
gospel of truth, and we must share it so that all brothers and sisters can come to the knowledge of spirit and truth and liberty in Jesus Christ.
Hallelujah.
Isn't that amazing? So you can be a contributor of that. Now afterwards we do share our message on YouTube as well. We met somebody yesterday, we ministered to him, he He only has YouTube, so there are people that doesn't have Facebook, so we do share it afterwards. It's unfortunately not a live stream to YouTube. With our mobile setup, it's not possible to do it at this stage, but we do share it afterwards so people can watch it afterwards. And we do share the audio on our WhatsApp group as well, and the audio and video to Telegram. So if you don't have YouTube or Facebook, we do have Telegram as well.
Yes.
So we can also share, we also share the video and audio to our Telegram group as well.
Wow, praise the Here.
Yes.
Baie platforms, baie dinge. En jy kan so lekker deel wees van die bediening. Wees wel gaan so lekker welkom op die blad en deel met ons wat in jou hart ook is. As daar ook vrae is, as daar comments is, in jou hart is ons die boodskap so bedien, as jy iets wil bijvoeg, dis net so amazing om dit te sien, so lekker deel saam met mekaar, en dis wat ons sê, mens wil amper net alles so by mekaar kan bring, en allemaal kan sien, elke keer as ons bedien, maar jy kan wel deel wees so op die comments, geniet het net saam met ons volgend.
Yes, amen, I see Kitty said somebody asked her to share Facey to them.
Oh, praise
to forward Facey to them, yes, so that is how the people can receive the gospel.
Yes.
At first, sometimes people don't want to listen to their grown-ups ministry. Although what Facey is ministering is anything but childish, it's very grown-up, it's mature. And it's amazing how to see how children do understand the gospel. Sure. If they are sitting in with their parents, watching the gospel, as little as 6, as 5 years old, they do understand what we are saying, praise the Lord, and we know it, because a lot of children, especially small children, they ask us questions, or they come back to us and say, "Woman Tani, you ministered that, and we heard this at school, and we heard it was not correct."
Wow.
And they listened with their parents to the adult ministry and understood what we were saying. And when they get to school, they realize and understand. But what is happening here? The gospel that preach here is not the correct gospel. Sure. Yes, amen.
Yeah, so dis vir ons riem onder die hart, dat die kinders het ook in die boodskappe, moet nie die kinders verhinder nie, dat hulle ook luister, en hulle neem baie in. Ek kan vir sê, mens denk baie keer, kinders hoor nie, hulle verstaan nie, maar as ons hoor wat sy vra die kinders, as ons by hulle kom kuier en so aan, en baie keer soms so op WhatsApp, dan vra hulle vraag, of hulle doen een comment, en dan kom jy achter, maar hierdie kinders verstaan, hulle verstaan die groot mens taal, mens denk baie keer, mens moet hulle in 'n ander taal probeer verduidelik in 'n baba taal, maar hulle verstaan wat die woord van die Here sê, want die Here maak het vir hulle duidelik, is dit nie amazing nie, en ja, so ons is opgewonde oor dit, en hulle kan vinnig hoor, wanneer daar 'n verkeerde evangelie uitgaan, en ander besoedel, nou, dan denk ek daar aan, baie keer is ons as groot mense so, ons eien van onself eindelijk toe, dat ons die geest van onderscheiding het, en as ek baie keer hoor, hoe die kinders die geest van onderscheiding het, dan denk ek, joh, Here, jy gee dit vir die kinderkies, jy maak het aan hulle bekend, want hulle harte is so oop, nou wat is die evangelie? Jou hart moet net oop wees vir die Here, jy moet net dit aanneem, wat uitgaan, en dan het jy die geest van onderscheiding, jy hoor vinnig op jou oor, want jou oor is besny, as jy die woord van die Here aanneem, en toepas, en deel maak van jou lewe, dan hoor jy vinnig, hier's 'n groot probleem. So ja, ons is opgewonde ook oor die kinders volgend, en oor Facey, dit is so lekker om vir Facey te doen, en hou ook op te neem in Swan, en dankie vir almal se insaag, ons het nou so 'n bietjie insaag gehad, en Ina het nou vir my so 2 boodskappe gestuur, wat ons dalk op Facey kan gebruik, ons kan daarmee werk, en ach, dit is net lekker om te sien, dat almal is opgewonde oor die evangelie, en hulle wil ook deel wees daarvan, wow, dit is amazing, en ons sal nou so 'n bietjie lekker dink om die maaikies in te trek, maar dit sal nou eers gebeur as ons klaar is met ons roadtrip. So ja, prys die Here.
Yes, amen. We must be circumcised by ear as well.
Amen.
I tried to find the verse quickly, but you can go read through Acts 7. That is where Stephen were stoned. He were persecuted for the gospel because of the good things he did. They were ministering to the poor widows, they were distributing food, and while they were distributing food, God's Spirit worked, and a lot of miracles took place in the process, because obviously where there is need, where people are poor, there is need, there's no money for doctors and good food, etc., so there is a lot of sickness and illness, And as they were distributing food, and sometimes we think it's a minor thing, it's actually a degrading thing to spread food. And remember, it was between the children of God. And at that moment, God confirmed their ministry, and he was doing miracles. And in the process, Stephen were persecuted and eventually stoned to death. And in his sermon, if I can put it like that, while he was preaching or telling the Pharisees what was going on, he said, "You are uncircumcised from heart and ear, and we must be circumcised by heart and ear."
Hallelujah. Ja, so ons harte en ons ore moet besny wees. Wow, dis amazing. Jou hart word besny wanneer jy die Here Jesus Christus aanneem in die wedergeboorte. Dis waar jou hart besny word, en dan soos wat jy die woord aanneem en toepas en aanvaar en deel maak van jou lewe, so word jou oor besny, maar dan moet jy hoor.
Yes,
en dit is wat Jesus die hele tyd gesê het, wie jou oor het, laat hom hoor. Wie se oor besny is, wie dit kan aanvaar, laat hy dit aanvaar. En dit is net so amazing, as mens die evangelie kan aanvaar, dan raak 'n mens los en vry, en daar kan soveel mooi dinge en 'n mens se lewe deurbreek. En jy is wel dan ook die evangelie van daai besnydenis verkondig, loof die Here.
Yes, wow. Amen. When we look here also, just as an introduction, hallelujah. Just a little introduction.
Nee.
We read also here in Hebrews 5, I just want to get to the specific verse that, He says, Hebrews 5 verse 11, Hebrews 5 verse 11, "Of whom we have much to say and hard to explain, since you have become dull of hearing." Now, if we become dull of hearing, in other words, we are sluggish to hear. I don't have time to listen now. That is when your ear is not circumcised.
Wow.
And that is when the gospel are becoming difficult, hard to explain.
Mm.
Paul says, I'm trying to, or the writer of Hebrews, nobody knows whether it was Paul or not, but he tried to explain this thing, and he found that the church, the children of God, couldn't understand what he was saying.
Wow.
Because they become dull, sluggish in hearing. They don't want to hear the complete, they don't want to sit and really understand and try to understand what he was saying.
So Hebreërs 5 vers 11, waar vir ons te veel te sê het, wat swaar is om te verklaar, omdat jy traag geword het om te hoor. Mm-hmm. En as 'n mens lei is om te hoor, kan ek vir jy sê, dit is moeilik om die woord te verstaan en te aanvaar, deel daarvan te raak, deel te raak van die evangelie. Mens moet bereid wees, dat hy oor van jou hoor, dat hy luister, dat jy sit en inneem en geleer word, so dat jy weer kan gaan leer.
Yes.
Want as jy nie geleer word nie, kan jy nie gaan leer nie. En dit is wanneer die mense oor besny is, wanneer jy bereid is, dan voel jy baie keer, joh, die boodskap was te kort, dan sê die aanhou, joh, die boodskappe is te lang. Dan denk jy, nee, ek wil nog hoor, want jou oor is besny, jy wil het aanneem, jy wil het deel van jou lewe maak, en dan voel het amper en daar nie, dit is nie genoeg wat jy hoor nie. So dan moet jy weet, daai oor van jou is besny.
Yes,
Sydney. Good morning, Sydney.
Good morning, Sydney. That is nice to hear. It's lazy. Lazy. We are lazy to hear. That is the correct word. And this is what my wife is saying. Some people will say after a ministry of 1.5 hours or an hour, wow, why is so short? And the other person will say, yuck, that was so long. And we must not become lazy to hear.
Devanai, jy moet luister.
Oh, are they busy watching mama with sê, mommy?
Baba slaap, sy kyk nie kerk nie. Nee, baba moet luister.
Ah, but at least the sound are going out. She is listening.
Ek skryf foto van baba wat slaap.
Sy is in die dakgemeente, sy het nie gehaard hierin nie.
Ons laaste vir die woord as babaatjie so bietjie moeilik raak, dan sê sy, luister die Devanai, jy is in die dakgemeente. Hier het ons nie geaardhede nie. Hier sort ons lewe uit. Ja, so dit is baie oulik.
Yes, I mean, praise the Lord. We are now in Brits, busy with our road trip in Gauteng and surrounding areas. We've been at the Free State, Fall Triangle, Beaufort West, that is in the Western Cape. We're still going to Mpumalanga, Middelburg. If the Lord willing, wherever still we need to go, the Lord will guide us and provide for us where we must go. And it's really an exciting time for my wife and myself. We really, really, really enjoy it.
Yes.
Still going to Joburg, Alberton, visit people there, congregation. Yes. And then next Sunday, the big wedding, 5th of May. If you are in the area, if you're part of the congregation, please contact us so that you can also come to the wedding. That will be 11 o'clock, the 5th of May in Van der Bijl Park.
Praise the Lord. So, first coming is Sondag, the 5th of May, 11 die oggend, is die Sondagoggend, gaan ons 'n troue hê. Dit is Isabel en Jacobus wat trou daar in Van der Bijl Park. By Jeugland Ouethuis is 'n saal. So hulle is nie in die Ouethuis nie. Hulle trou net by die saal by die Ouethuis. So mense vra of ons is hulle in die Ouethuis nie. Hulle is nie. So ja, ons gaan hulle daar trou. Ons is opgewonde. Almal help met reëlings en dinge. Hier is sommer baie reëlings hier tussen ons almal. Tafeldoeke en troukoek en platters en allerhande dinge. So ja, ons is opgewonde dat die Here ook daar vir hulle kan deurbreek. En ons wil natuurlik ook weer eens die gemeente uitnooi. Elkeen wat kan, al ken jy hulle nie, jy moet hulle kom leer ken.
Yes,
want dit is jou broer en suster in die Here. So al yes. ken jy hulle nie, kom asseblief troue toe en ons gaan daar wees. Ons kan weer lekker saamkom, net so 'n bietjie tyd saam spandeer, maar bevestig met ons en dan kan ons ook so lekker gesels en net vir jou al die reëlingkies deurgee.
Yes, amen. Praise the name of the Lord. We're going to start our ministry, this our sermon this morning, or our fellowship.
Yes,
sir. Not our sermon, eh?
Yeah,
we don't want to preach.
Ons kajer saam.
Yeah, we don't want to preach anymore. Just the fellowship, kajer with each other. We're going to start with prayer. And first, we're going to do the communion. That is just for logistical purposes. And then afterwards, we're going to minister the word of God.
Amen.
Amen. Heavenly Father, we thank you that we have the privilege once again this morning to carry your word, to preach your word, to blow the trumpets, Father, that we can be part of the Feast of Trumpets this morning,
Amen.
Father. We can blow the trumpet of the gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ in this entire world, Father, to every house, to every home, Father, to every nook and cranny,
yeah.
wherever a person has a cell phone, wherever a person has technology, a PC where he can, Father, can tune in on Facebook or YouTube or WhatsApp. Lord, this message can go forth. It can save souls, Lord.
Amen.
But what is most exciting is when we minister, while we are ministering the gospel, we also minister to the powers and the spirits in the air, Father. Hallelujah. Your angels are listening, Father. The demons are watching and listening. Yes, Lord. Hallelujah. And we thank you that we have the privilege, hallelujah, to spread this gospel, hallelujah, in the name of your Son, Jesus Christ, in the entire world, in the entire spiritual world. Hallelujah. And once, when one soul gets saved there, your angels, Father, are joyful. Hallelujah. We read in your word that there is gladness, there is joy in heaven when one soul gets saved, when one soul gets delivered. Hallelujah. We thank you, Father, in the name of your Son,
Amen.
Jesus Christ, that this morning you can use this message. We pray that you will use this message as well to save souls, those who have not been born again. Lord, you can use this message. You can guide our mouth, Lord, to say something that can, Father, change a person's heart, that he can come, Father, to the knowledge of your Son, Jesus Christ, and eternal life, that he can be convicted of his sin, and that he can repent from his sin, his sinful life and his sinful ways, whether it's man or woman. Father, your spirit draws everyone. There's no partiality, Father.
Yeah,
there's no special nationality. There's no special race, Father. There's no special language. No. Everybody in this world are created and have been created by your will. And we thank you for that. And it's your will that every soul will be saved, that every soul will come to the knowledge of your Son, Jesus Christ. And you can use this ministry this morning so that it can reach to the most Father, hallelujah, uttermost yes. places in Amen. This world. Hallelujah. We thank you for that, Lord. We thank you. And we ask you that you will guide us this morning, and that you will lay words in our hearts and in our minds that we can speak the truth, Father, because it is the truth that set us free. Amen. It's not our own interpretation of your word, but if we can interpret it in truth and in spirit, that is when it can set people free, set Amen. Souls free. And we ask you, Father, please guide us and help us this morning. We are really in need of thee. Amen. We thank you in Jesus' name.
Baie dankie, Here, dat ons net weer in die teenwoordigheid kan wees. Dankie, Here, dat ons die voorreg het om die woord te kan bedien en saam met ons broers en susters, Here, so op die lig te kuier en net deel van mekaar se lewens te kan wees, in mekaar te kan belê, mekaar te kan bou en stig en opbou en toerus vir die dienswerk wat elkeen moet doen. Here, en ek besef, Vader, dit gaan nie net om 'n boodskap te hoor vanoggend nie. Dit gaan, Here, om uit te gaan, Vader, sodat jy gestig is, sodat jy ander kan, Here, gaan leer en lei en Here, gaan red en verlos en vrymaak met die woord en met die krag van U, Here, wat ons hier ontvang, Vader. Ons sê vir U so baie dankie. Ek wil bid, Here, dat U my en my man help vanoggend. U weet, ons is so afhanklik van U vanoggend, Here, terwyl ons op die pad is en by almal is en kuier, is daar min tyd, Here, om werklik net, Here, uit te sorteer, maar Vader, in dit werk jy en jy praat en jy deel in ons harte en jy sorteer uit en jy gee vir ons soveel mooie idees en dinge en vrae wat beantwoord kan word en Here, jy is net so kragtig en heerlik as ons net besig is met die koninkryk. Here, dan voeg jy alles by, Vader, wat ons nodig het, die woord en alles wat ons moet bedien. En ons sê net vanoggend vir U so baie dankie dat U ons help, dat U ons, Here, versterk, dat U ons krag gee, dat U ons ou liggame aanraak vanoggend, Here, baie baie dankie daarvoor. Amen. En dat ons in blydskap en in heerlikheid die woord van U kan bedien, Vader, want baie keer is jou liggaam, Here, hy wil mense hier downtrack, want hy is nou moeg, Vader, maar vanoggend is ons opgewonde en bly in U, Here, want die woord gee lewe, die woord maak ons vry en los, en Here, jy bring verlossing en vrymaking, en ons dankie net vanoggend, Here, ons is so opgewonde, Here, vir die pad wat U vir ons het, Here, dankie dat U ons lei en help, en Here, wat U vir ons, Here, die pad maak, waarheen ons moet gaan, waar ons moet uitkom, ons kon nie niemand, Here, kan ons gering ag nie, Here, niemand kan ons gering skat nie, Vader, elkeen is U kind, en ons wil by elkeen uitkom wat U beplan, en Here, uitsorteer, en vir ons die pad maak, en ons sê net vir U so baie dankie, dat ons net op U kan vertrou vanoggend, dat U vir ons uitgaan, baie, baie dankie, Here, en lei ons vanoggend, en help ons, in die kragtige naam van U Seun Jesus Christus, Amen.
Amen, praise the name of the Lord, while my wife were praying, I was just thinking once again, yesterday we had a baptism service of Jacques Kok there in Oranjeville van der Belt Park, and once again when I read this scripture about the baptism in Matthew 28 verses 19, it is just a reminder of how to conduct our and what is the purpose of our spiritual life. He says here in Matthew 28, verses 19. Will you be tablet werk?
Ach, it's fine. Okay.
He said, go therefore and make disciples of all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit, teaching them to observe all things that I've commanded you.
Wow.
So that is amazing. We must not just go and baptize. We must make disciples of all nations and teach them to observe. And while we become a disciple, eventually we must become a disciple maker and teach each other to observe everything and to be obedient to everything in God's word.
Sjoe, sê so mooi, Matteus 28 vers 19. Gaan dan heen. Maak disciples van al die nasies en doop hulle in die naam van die Vader en die Seun en die Heilige Gees en leer hulle om alles te onderhou wat ek julle beveel het. Want het help nie, die mens doop net en jy lei net tot bekering en jy leer nie daarna nie. Want dan gaan jy weer sterf, jy gaan weer afvallig raak, terugsak. Want dan gaan jy niks hê om te verstaan in die woord van die Here nie. So ons moet altyd daar wees om mekaar te leer, te onderrig en te help en antwoorde te gee, op te bou, te stig en toe te rus, en dit is net amazing, dit help nie net om een ding te doen nie, want die persoon wat gered moet word en verlos moet word en gedoop word, moet weer een disipelmaker gaan word, hy moet weer die evangelie verder gaan uitdra, so dat die evangelie kan versprei.
Yeah, because unfortunately we stand still at our spiritual rebirth, and obviously baptism. Now, baptism is the big thing nowadays. People get baptized without being born again. You must be first born again, then baptized. The baptism isn't the spiritual rebirth, and that's what we must understand. And even if we are born again and baptized, it's as if we are sluggish. It is as if we are depending on our baptism and not learn to do everything that God commands us.
Wow.
And that is very, very... There must be a spiritual growth. You cannot stand still at your baptism and say to yourself, soul, rest, you are now baptized. No, there is a spiritual walk and a spiritual growth and maturity that what must happen in your spiritual life.
Sure, it's my mind to think, wanneer jy tot wedergeboorte gekom het en gedoop is, kan jy nie daarby stilstaan nie. Jy moet verder groei. Jy moet aangaan. En baie keer is dit so dat die mens gaan stilstaan by jou doop en by jou wedergeboorte en voel, ach, ek is nou gered. Maar dit is nie die pad nie. Die pad gaan aan. Jy moet groei, jy moet verby dinge groei, jy moet opstaan, jy moet volwasse raak in die woord van die Here. En dit is hoekom mens moet leer en aangaan in die woord van die Here en bereid wees om te hoor en te luister en aan te neem.
Yes, amen. Let's continue to the communion Lord's Supper. And our main scripture reading this morning will be from 1 Corinthians 11. But I feel that's so upset.
I think that's going to be fair for me.
Yeah, but sit on us a bit now.
Okay.
Yes.
It's so oulik.
Yes, naturally.
This is so oulik.
We must be helpians.
Yeah.
Yes, we must be helpians. 1 Corinthians 11, we're going to read from verse 23. And after we've read the scripture, we're going to... And then we're going to serve the communion. 1 Corinthians 11 from verse 23. For I received from the Lord that which I also delivered to you, that the Lord Jesus, on the same night in which he was betrayed, took bread. And when he had given thanks, he broke it and said, take, eat. This is my body, which is broken for you. Do this in remembrance of me. In the same manner, he also took the cup after the supper, saying, this cup is the new covenant in my blood. Do this as often as you drink it in remembrance of me. For as often as you eat this bread and drink this cup, you proclaim that the Lord's death till he comes. What is quite amazing, what really stands out to me this morning, in remembrance of me.
Sure.
Now, Jesus Christ died. We must remember he died for our sins. He suffered, he died for our sins, and he also rose from the dead. That's very important to understand that as well. So when we do take part of the Holy Communion this morning, we think of our Lord Jesus Christ that died on the cross for our sins, so that he can destroy the works of the devil. And what is the works of the devil? It is sin. It's iniquity that he came to destroy. And when we do it with that mindset and with that thought in our heart and conviction in our heart, then we can take part of the communion.
Sure, that's mooi. 1 Corinthians 11 vanaf vers 23. Want ek het van die Here ontvang wat ek ook aan julle oorgelewer het, dat die Here Jesus in die nag waarin hy verraai is brood geneem het, en nadat hy gedank het, het hy dit gebreek en gesê, neem eet, dit is my liggaam wat vir julle gebreek word, doen dit tot my gedagtenis. Sê net so ook die beker na die ete met die woorde, hierdie beker is die Nuwe Testament in my bloed, doen dit so dikwels as julle daaruit drink tot my gedagtenis. Want so dikwels as julle hierdie brood eet en hierdie beker drink, verkondig julle die dood van die Here totdat hy kom. So is dit nie mooi nie. Elke keer wat ons die nagmaal gebruik, verkondig ons ook die dood van die Here. Maar hy het ook opgestaan uit die dode en ons glo dit in ons harte. En dit is hoekom ons die Here Jesus Christus aangeneem het as die Seun van God in die wedergeboorte. En dit is wat ons verkondig. Elke keer wanneer ons hierdie sakrament gebruik, dan manifesteer jy dit wat al reeds in jou hart is. Jy sê vir almal, jy dis 'n bewys wat jy lewer van dis wat ek glo in my hart. Die Here Jesus Christus het Thomas het dood gegaan. Hy is gekruisig, maar hy het ook opgestaan uit die dode vir ons en hy het ons sonde kom verlos en vrymaak en ons ook van die bose kom verlos en die duivel kom oorwin. So dis alles wat jy verkondig wanneer jy die nagmaal gebruik.
Yes, amen. Isn't that quite amazing? We think of our Lord Jesus Christ, how he died and rose from the dead. And maybe we must just clarify the next two verses, because we had an issue regarding this.
Yeah.
And let us read the following three verses, actually, from verse 27 up to verse 30. 27 to 30. Therefore, whoever eat this bread or drink this cup of the Lord in an unworthy manner will be guilty of the body and blood of the Lord. But let a man examine himself, and so let him eat of the bread and drink of the cup. For he who eats and drinks in an unworthy manner eats and drinks judgment to himself, not discerning the Lord's body. For this reason many are weak and sick among you and sleep. That sleep is literally dead. He died. Okay. So the Lord says if we use the Lord's Supper in an unworthy manner, we bring judgment on ourselves. And sometimes we feel as if we are condemned, we are judged. Now, what does this mean? First of all, it's going to be something brief, just to encourage you today. If you are a child of God, born again, first of all, you must be born again. An unbelieving, non-circumcised heart person cannot use the Holy Communion. Children who are not born again cannot use the Holy Communion. That's part of the unworthy. Here's a specific example, but it's all part and parcel of using communion in an unworthy manner. In other words, if you give your children who are not born again communion, you actually bringing a judgment over your own children or family members, whoever it might be. And even yourself, if you are not born again. And if you are born again, you must understand and comprehend what it is all about. And the Holy Communion is a sacrament. In other words, it's something, it's a once-off visible thing that we do, manifestation of something that we are walking in our entire life. So every day we must eat of Christ and we must drink of his blood. How do we eat of Christ? We eat of his word. We have communion with him. What is Jesus Christ's blood? That is his life. And when we sin, we confess our sin, then the blood of Jesus Christ cleanses us from that sin. So if you walk in that daily life, the only thing when you are using the communion, you are only acting what is really in your heart. So it's not a question if you have sin or not sin. Do you confess it? Do you feel guilty about it? So if you are upright, if you are serving the Lord, if you are born again, by all means, use the communion.
So ja, wie dan op onwaardige wijze hierdie brood eet of die beker van die Here drink, sal skuldig wees aan die lichaam en die bloed van die Here. Maar die mens moet homself beproef en so van die brood eet en uit die beker drink. Nou, baie mense voel baie bang en vreesachtig om die nagmaal te gebruik. Kinders van die Here wat wel hulle harte vir die Here gegee het, wat besny is in die hart, wat die gees van die Here ontvang het, voel dat hulle kan dit dalk net op onwaardige wyse gebruik en dan kan daar oordeel oor hulle kom. Maar as 'n mens kan verstaan, en dit is nou so mooi wat Stanley nou so verduidelik, wel, dit het my nou nogal getref, as jy daarin kan stap, dat jy die brood wat jy eet is die woord van die Here, as dit deel is van jou lewe, as jy dit aanneem en toepas en deel maak van jou lewe, en die bloed is die lewe van Jesus Christus, is die vergifnis, die verlossing, die vrymaking, so wanneer jy jou dagelikse pad in die evangelie stap, en jy val en jy struikel, en jy bely jou sonde, en jy weet, die bloed van Jesus Christus was jou skoon, die lewe van Jesus Christus was jou skoon, dan is dit daai pad wat jy dagelik stap, jy ywer na reinheid en waarheid, en jy wil die woord toepas, en jy wil dit doen, dan mag jy die nagmaal gebruik, want dit is jou dagelikse wandel en handel, so dit kom ooreen met dit wat jy kom manifesteer wanneer jy nagmaal gebruik.
Yes.
Jy kom sê net met 'n uiterlike daad, dis wat ek in my pad glo, en dis hoe ek kom stap, en dis wat ek toepas en doen, so dan weet een mens, maar ek gebruik die bloed van Jesus, die lewe van Jesus Christus, reg. Ek eer die woord en ek pas dit toe en het reinig my en het maak my skoon, so dit is 'n daaglikse pad. So dan kan jy deel wees van die nagmaal. Dit gaan nie net oor struikel en val en sonde en dinge wat 'n onwaardige wyse is om die nagmaal te gebruik. Want mense raak vreesagtig, hulle voel, "Sjoe, dalk moet ek dit eerder nie gebruik nie. Nou doen ek dit net op 'n verkeerde manier." Maar jy kan dit vir geen ander mens aanbied wat nie tot wedergeboorte gekom het nie. Elkeen wat dit gebruik, sy hart moet besny wees. Jy kan dit nie vir jou kinders gee wat nie hulle harte vir die Here gegee het nie, want dan kan daar 'n oordeel oor jou kinders kom. So ons moet net wakker wees in hierdie dinge, so jy as kind van die Here wat die dinge glo, wat dit toepas, wat die lewenspad stap en handel en wandel, jy mag dit gebruik.
Yes, amen. Praise the Lord. Now let us continue to the serving of the bread and the grape juice. The bread is a symbol of Jesus Christ's body. And when we eat of this bread, we confess and we act that that we are part of the body of our Lord Jesus Christ. And if we are part of His body, we are members of each other as well. Amen. And the blood of Jesus Christ, that is His life.
Amen.
Yes, His life that He gave us. And it's not the blood that were shed on the cross. It is life now. His resurrected life. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord.
Is daar nog wel om te gebruik? Dankie vir verduideliking. Ja, mens moet nie bang wees om dit te gebruik nie. Jy moet net dit wat jy in jou pad stap, moet jy net verstaan. En dan kan jy jou dagmaal gebruik. As jy bereid is om jou hart skoon te maak, jou sonde te bely, te verstaan die bloed, die lewe van Christus maak jou skoon en vry en jy bely jou sonde en ongeregtigheid, hoef jy nooit vreesagtig te wees om die nagmaal te gebruik nie.
What actually came to mind when we had this issue and we spoke to the person, when you are not living a life, it's not about struggling and having sin. If you feel guilty, you confess, that is the road of holiness. So yes, you want to cleanse your teeth. Sometimes you might be so frustrated and saying, what does it help to confess? But still at the end you do confess. So you are living the life. You are reading the word. You are praying. So in on a daily basis you have communion with the Lord Jesus Christ. Now what happens if you don't walk that road and you use the communion, you are actually lying. Because the only communion is supposed to be the acting, the visible manifestation and proof of how you conduct your life every day. Otherwise, you are busy with a lie. And that is when we are bringing judgment on ourselves, because we are lying to our fellow brothers and sisters and also lying towards God and the angels of God.
Ja, so wanneer jy die pad stap en jy doen wat jy moet doen, mag jy die nagmaal gebruik, maar baie keer stap ons 'n pad van gefeitsheid. Jy maak asof jy die Here dien. Jy gee voor dat jy die Here dien. En dan kan jy nie gaan manifesteer. Dit is die pad wat ek daagliks stap en dit is wat ek lewe nie. Want dan is dit 'n leuen. Dan wil jy jou medebroers en susters eintlik om die bos lei. So dit is eintlik waaroor dit gaan. En maar as 'n mens daai baie keer het jy 'n struggle. Daar's baie dinge en baie goed, maar jy daai ywer, jy wil, daar's 'n wil, jy wil. Dit is net wanneer 'n mens moedswillig raak en afvallig raak en voorgee dat jy nog is waar jy moet wees, maar jy is nie, dan lieg jy.
Yes, amen. So Jesus Christ, He took the bread, and we must understand the communion is the fulfillment of the Passover. So it was a feast.
Yeah.
It was a feast meal as well. And at the meal there were bread. And He took that bread and He used it as a symbol. He used it and He took the bread and he started talking about the bread that was in His hand. But first, before we're going to go to and breaking the bread and serving it to each other, we first going to pray, because the Bible says when Jesus took this bread, He blessed it. So let us first pray before we take part of the communion. Heavenly Father, we thank You for the privilege once again that we can, Lord, have an outward manifestation of our inward belief. And I thank You, Father, this is a privilege that we can share with each other. We can share it with the world today, that we believe in the Lord Jesus Christ, who came in the flesh, who died in the flesh, who rose from the dead, who went into heaven with a changed body. His body is not in the grave anymore. It didn't decay in the grave. It changed into a heavenly body. And I thank you, Father, that we have the privilege and we have the knowledge to understand this. But today, we don't want to keep it to ourselves. We want to spread it to the whole world so that the entire world can understand what the reality of the Lord Jesus Christ is. He died not just to die. He died to overcome the works of the devil and to destroy him who had power over death. Yes, we read in Hebrews 2, Lord, that Jesus, that the devil had power over death. He had power over the soul of humanity. And everybody in the Old Testament, up till Jesus Christ, when they died, they went into hell, they went into Hades, because the devil had power over their souls once they died. And Jesus Christ, you came, and when we believe in you, you, Father, destroy that power. So when we die in you, Lord, we are going to heaven, because you have the power over our soul and our mind to accept us into your eternal kingdom. I thank you, Lord. This bread thank today you. Is a symbol of your body that has been broken for us.
Amen.
And every day we partake of your body. And Lord Jesus Christ, even the blood that you shed, you died on that cross, and now there's a resurrection life. And we want to celebrate it in our heart today, Lord, that we are partakers of your body and of your blood. And your blood has been shed for the forgiveness of sins. And I thank you for that, Lord. Please bless this Holy Communion, everybody who partakes of it today, so that we can be delivered from our sinful lives. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen.
Yes, you can take the bread. Can just take a little piece and just break it. Anything that are bread-like, you can use. Amen. You can take a piece and you can eat of it.
Yeah.
And then after the supper, Jesus Christ took the wine. We used the grape juice. And it's also a symbol of the wine. It's a symbol of Jesus Christ's blood. And he said, this blood is the blood of the New Testament for the forgiveness of sins. That's the purpose of Jesus Christ's blood. And you can take a sip of the grape juice. Praise the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. We believe that everybody took part of the communion. You're live on Facebook. And even afterwards, you can also take part of the communion with us. Yes. Hallelujah. So we are going... so we're going to continue with the ministry of the Word of God today. As the Lord has laid it on our hearts. And actually, when we are on a road trip, there's a lot of questions and issues, and the Lord really gives wisdom and understanding so that we can talk things through and issues so that it can be answers. And today's ministry is going to be, I think, a few topics that we handled, and we just want to share it with you because obviously you are not with us.
Yeah.
And as I'm
saying, the whole time, almal kan by wees om te hoor wanneer ons so lekker gesels.
Yeah, so we actually want to put up a live camera all the time when we sit and we minister. And it feels to us that we are having church every single day. But then we realized, actually yesterday, we realized we had a sermon last week Sunday.
Yes.
But thank you for your patience with us as well. And that you also... gee die geleentheid.
Give us the opportunity.
And ek wil sê dat dat mense hulle lief die dat hulle broeders sisters gestig gaan word, dat hulle geduldig is dat hulle broeders en sisters.
Yeah, that your patience, that your brothers and sisters can be uplift
yes.
with the word of God.
Yes,
thank
amen.
Thank you for your patience.
Yeah. Yes, amen. Hallelujah. Now, I wonder if you have ever wondered...
I think die nagmaal het volgens vir almal...
Is it?
...dalk een ander betekenis.
Is
nie
it?
Nie net een ander betekenis, die dalk verstaan.
Yes.
Want ek denk dit is... almal sê dit is baie mooi verduidelik, want Die groot ding is baie keer is, en dit is wat ons vanoggend gebid het ook, baie keer is daar onsekerheid. En dan kan 'n mens nie iets met sekerheid doen nie. Maar wanneer 'n mens dit in sekerheid verstaan, ja, as daai onkunde gaan, dan is mens seker.
Yes,
en dit is waaroor die trip ook gaan. En dit is wat 'n mens besef, jy kom nie by elke broer en suster uit elke dag om te hoor wat se issues is daar nie. En dan, wanneer 'n mens sit tussen almal is, dan kom dit dan kom onderwerpe op en vrese en benoudhede en dinge wat nie verstaan word nie. En wanneer daai onkunde kan gaan, dan lewe ons in vryheid. En dan kan ons weer groei, want baie keer stak mens by 'n punt.
Yes, amen. And we must just learn to serve the Lord in spirit and truth without unnecessary fear.
Amen.
We must always fear the Lord, and that is respect Him to do His word. And if we don't do it, that is when we fear.
Ja, en die ding is, ek dink baie keer ook met die Bybelskool wat ons doen, word daar soveel dinge bespreek en uitgesorteer en dinge, want jy moet verstaan in jou hart wat die student is wat dit leer, so dat daar nie meer onkunde in jou hart nie, so dat as mense vir jou vra, dat jy dit ook kan gaan verduidelik.
Yes.
Maar baie keer, wanneer ons dinge in daai erns verstaan en sien in die Bybelskool, dan begin 'n mens vreesagtig raak, en dan is jy nie meer vrymoedig met die evangelie nie. So dit is net om jou daai sekerheid te gee, dat wanneer iemand jou vra, dat jy ook kan beantwoord, en dat jou hart kan los en vrykom. Dit gaan nie om te vrees nie. So ek dink as ons kan vandag verstaan, die kennis wat ons inkry, moet net lewend gemaak word deur die gees van die Here. Dan kan mens in daai vrymoedigheid en opgewondenheid bly stap. En alles wat jy doen in die Bybelskool, al die kennis, al die dienste wat jy bywoon en so aan, wat jy dinge hoor, bid daaroor dat die gees van die Here dit vir jou lewend maak. Dat dit nie vir jou 'n wet is en 'n vreesagtige saak nie. Want dan kan mens nie die Here in vryheid dien nie.
Yes, we must just serve the Lord in spirit and truth. The Bible school out there, and it touches on a lot of points. It actually brings the entire, it gives us perspective on, say for instance, like the communion. It gives us perspective what is the reality thereof. But we must not fear, because there's a lot of issues in our hearts. And when we, as I've written the Bible school, I realize that there's so many facets, and we need to address every facet to so that you can be educated as well. When you are in the presence of somebody and he asks you a question, that you can answer him in steadfastness and in surety of heart.
Amen.
So that you can minister the gospel. But serve the Lord in joyfulness and spirit and truth, and gladness in your heart.
Yes.
And if you are upright, if there's something wrong, the Lord will help you. He will sort you out. Don't you worry. He sorted Paul out. He will sort us out. He sorts everybody out. But if you are really excited and upright in your heart, please do serve the Lord. But then you know, there's also earnestness. There's also reality. But don't fear it. Just serve the Lord.
Amen.
Praise the name of the Lord.
Dit is so mooi. I'm sure. Rwaida sê, ek het van kindsbeen af daai vrees vir nagmaal gehad.
Wow.
En dit is baie keer daai vrees wat mens terughou in jou geestelike lewe. Want jy vrees eintlik die verkeerde dinge. En op die verkeerde manier. Want eintlik voel mens, God is 'n wrede God. Jy is amper te bang om iets aan iets deel te hê wat met God te doen het.
Yes.
Omdat 'n mens baie keer in 'n harde evangelie groot word, in 'n gestrenge en wat nie volgens die woord van die Here is nie. En al daai dinge moet afval, en so met die dienste en so met kuiers en so aan, wanneer jy vra, en dit is hoekom ons almal so aanmoedig. As daar iets vir jou onduidelik is, moenie dit los dat dit verbygaan nie. Vra onmiddellik, vra, en dan kan jy sekerheid hê, en so van daar af kan jy aangaan. Want baie keer, daai vraag wat jy het, dan word dit nou nie daar beantwoord nie, maar jy stap daar. Jy gaan nie verder as dit nie. Maar sodra dit beantwoord word, dan gaan jy aan.
Yes, amen, praise the Lord. Now, on that point, I wonder if you have ever read the scripture and thought about it and wondered what it was all about. I'm just going to read one verse in the Hebrews, Revelation, because I know a lot of people just fear reading Revelation. You should not fear reading Revelation. Yeah. He says, you are blessed if you read and hear and listen to Revelation, what is written in here, and you do what is written in here, and then you are blessed, you are happy, because if you understand Revelation according to the Spirit of God, the truth of God's word, it's really exciting to read out of Revelation.
So waar lees ons?
Ja, Openbaring 11.
Ja.
Wat jy dan ook gaan vertaal het, poppies, wat ek nou net gesê, om salig te wees, opgewonde te wees.
Die woord van die Here sê, as jy Openbaring lees, dan is jy salig, as jy dit toepas en doen en aanneem,
yes.
Dan is jy gelukkig, jy is salig, so ons moet nie bang wees vir die boek van Openbaring nie, ons moet opgewonde wees om die boek van Openbaring te lees en dit te verstaan, volgens die woord van die Here, dan sal jy nie die vreesachtigheid hê nie, en baie keer vrees ons Openbaring so, dat ons kon afsny, as jy hoor, daar word uit Openbaring uit gelees, of jy voel, dit moet net oor die eindtyd gaan. En dit is so mooi Stanley verduidelik vir iemand, dit is dinge wat bespreek word, wat was, wat is en wat kom.
Yes,
so amen, baie dinge yes. Het al gebeur, baie dinge is besig om te gebeur en baie dinge moet nog gebeur.
Yes, so if you read in Revelation and then you must understand, John had this vision almost 2,000 years ago. And the Lord said to him already in Revelation 1, there's things that was, in other words, things that have already passed until he got the revelation. Because to understand the things that are busy happening and in the future, there must be a history. So God gave him a little bit, step, a little bit backward, gave him some history and showed him, okay, this is where this comes from.
Yes.
From there, from Jesus Christ's death, etc. And this will happen right until the end. So now we have a full picture where things started, what are busy happening up till the end. And only actually the only outstanding thing that must happen is the second coming of our Lord Jesus Christ.
Nee, die wederkoms me nog plaas.
Yes, amen.
Wow, dis super cool.
Okay, but let us read there in Revelation 11, and this is about the two witnesses that will be ministering a certain time. The Bible says it's 42 months, that's almost 3.5 years. Now, I don't want to go into detail, but I can tell you one thing. The 3.5 years is symbolic. It's yes. Not literal 3.5 years. Why do I say so? Because at one stage, Jesus Christ says, you cannot add one L. I think English is also L. Yeah, I think one L. It's a hand breadth to your length. And then we read in Psalms that L is time. It's not a physical measurement. So yes, a lot of times are also symbolic. It's not literal.
Ja, so die 3.5 jaar wat hy hiervan praat is nie presiese tyd nie. Dit is simbolies van tyd. So ja, as ons ook lees van jy kan geen L by jou lengte voeg nie, kom ons ook agter in Psalms praat hy daarvan, dit gaan oor 'n tyd.
Yes.
Dit gaan oor dit wat jy nie kan byvoeg in jou lewe nie.
Jy kan nie tyd verleng
in jou lewe nie. God besluit jou tyd. En dit is ook wat ons in Openbaring kry, dat dit is simbolies van aard.
Yes.
Die tydvakke wat hy van praat.
Yes, the one time, the one time period is just longer than the other one.
Yeah.
Okay, let us read verse 6. These have power to shut heaven. Now, this is the two witnesses. These have power to shut heaven so that no rain falls in the days of their prophecy. And they have power over waters to turn them to blood and to strike the earth with all plagues as often as they desire. Now, if you're going to read in the rest of Revelation, we read about all these plagues, etc. And the two witnesses will be responsible for a lot of things that will happen in this world. And the devil knows who they are, and the devil knows they are responsible because of their ministry, because they are witnesses and they must prophesy. So what is the prophecy and the witness? They witness about the Lord Jesus Christ. The prophecy that they utter is just ministering the word of God. It's not something that are not in the word of God, is just revealing the truth of God's words and prophesy, minister that once again about the Lord Jesus Christ. Hallelujah.
Ons lees Openbaring 11 vanaf vers 6. Dit gaan oor die twee getuienisse. Hulle het mag om die hemel te sluit, sodat daar in die dag van hulle profesie geen reën val nie, en hulle het mag oor die waters om dit in bloed te verander, en om die aarde te tref met allerhande plaag, so dikwels as hulle wil. So hierdie twee getuienisse, die profetiese, die profesie wat hy hiervan praat, terwyl hulle hierdie profetiese woord uiter gaan oor die bediening van die woord van die Here. So hulle getuig net weer van die waarheid van die woord. Bring net weer die waarheid van die woord aan die lig wat vermis was, wat onderdruk was. Bring hulle weer aan die lig en hulle getuig daarvan, hulle bedien dit aan die volk. So yes. Dit is waaroor dit gaan.
Yes, now what always hindered me and I always had a question about this, that no rain shall fall in the days of their prophecy. Now, when we look at a symbolism of rain, and now here he's not talking about physical rain. What is rain? What is water? Water is also the word of God. Now, as thou are ministering the word of God, in there, while thou are ministering the word of God, and he also says that fire proceeds from their mouth. Now, we read in Jeremiah that God says, my word is fire. So we can see here, it's the words of God that are fire. And while thou are ministering the word of God, no rain will fall. Now, how must we understand it? I'm just asking you here on Facebook Live, have you ever read a scripture and have you ever wondered about it? Why is it that they will minister the word of God, but no rain will fall on earth? What does it mean?
Ja, so gaan hierdie reën wat nie gaan val nie, gaan dit oor fysiese reën of waaroor gaan dit? En ons lees so mooi ook terwyl hulle woord uitgaan, terwyl hulle getuig van die ware woord van die Here, dan sit ook vuur in hulle monde. Nou in Jeremia word dit so mooi beskryf dat die Here het gesê dat die woord is soos 'n vuur in sy mond. So dis die woord wat uitgaan, dit is die woord van waarheid,
yes.
Wat weer aan die lig kom, wat weer uitgedra word, yes. Is die vuur, want dit maak dat die sonde verteer word in harte, of dat hulle die Here aanneem, of dat hulle die Here verwerp. So die vuur maak dat jy of gereinig word en aanneem, of
yes,
dit maak dat jy verteer word. So dit is wat die woord van die Here doen, en die woord van die Here is ook water. So is hierdie reën fysiese reën of waaroor gaan dit?
Yes, amen. Let us know in the comments so that we can talk to each other so that we can have clarity regarding the situation. Now, when we... Yeah.
Yes, ek is bezig om die les van die twee getuies en daar gewonder. Dankie vir die boodskap wat alles duidelik maak. Nee, ek het hier ons nog niks duidelik nie. Jy moet vir ons het duidelik maak. So, waaroor gaan die reën? Ek het nog altyd gewonder of dit... Fysiese reën is sê warmer. Praat bietjie met ons.
Yes, amen.
Ook al gewonder sê Sandra.
Yes, amen.
Van wanneer gaan die son onder? Ja, maar ons valse evangelies. Die gees, die reën is die gees, is dit nie? Okay, dit sê Paula.
Yes.
En reed sê valse evangelies met 'n vraagteken.
Now, let us just clarify Riet's question quickly. Jesus Christ said, the tares are sown amongst the good grain, and both will grow,
yes,
until the day of the harvest. That is the second coming. So the false gospel will continue until the second coming of our Lord Jesus Christ.
Yeah, so die verse is om die onkruid en die graan groei saam. So, dit gaan nie verwyder word voor die tyd nie, dit gaan eers met die wederkoms, dis die oesdag, gaan dit geopenbaar word, wat is graan en wat is onkruid. So, dit gaan groei en saam met die waarheid groei tot by die oesdag, tot by die wederkoms.
Yes.
Ok, Kathleen sê, Fransie sê, hy dink dit is die woord wat uitgaan, maar die mense gaan nie die ware woord aanvaar nie. En Paula sê, ek bedoel die reën verteenwoordig die gees. Ok.
Dit is net dit net gestig. Ja, dit sê alles.
Waar is die lange baaners en die houtfielders en die
ja.
Mense en middelburgers en waar is julle?
We don't even see them.
I see not a far away all at on in houtfield, maar waar is die ander houtfielders? Nie fisies nie, dis die Heilige Gees sê Ria. Yeah. Kitty sê, dan is reën seker die onkruid wat groei tussen die goeie saad. Ooh, hier sê verwarringkie.
Now, before we're going to continue, now a few sermons ago, fellowships ago, we determined that we had all the scriptures in place and it's also we write it in our...
Paskies, ek het hier, daarom sê, dit is die geestelike reën.
Okay. And we also wrote it in various places in our Bible school. This world is symbolic of the desert. Okay? That's why the Bible says this harlot woman are sitting on the beast in the desert. It is this world. The desert is a symbol of this world. I just want to say it first of all before we're going to continue.
Ja, so hierdie wêreld is die woestyn.
Yes.
So dit is ek om die woord sê dat die hoervrou Babylon sit in die, op hierdie dier in die woestyn. So hierdie wêreld word ook gesimboliseer as die woestyn.
Yes, amen.
Nog nie gelees nie, maar dink dis geestelik, sê Lindy. Irina sê die gees van God, Elmarie, die woord is die rivier wat die sonde verteer en die mens heilig wat dit aanvaar, hulle wat dit verwerp word verteer daardeur, die reën is die gees van God.
Okay. Now, when we think of a desert or a wilderness, there is no rain. It's not a place that are known for rain to fall down.
Yeah.
Okay. So, and this is the big problem we do have in the Christian church nowadays. There is an anticipation of, and it's not just in every generation, periodically, everybody expects some revival. That this rain will pour down and everybody will just accept the Lord Jesus Christ in the entire world. Have you ever heard it? Have you ever been there? Have you ever said it to yourself? That we all are in this anticipation that this mighty revival is going to hit the world. And then the second coming will be. Will it happen or won't it happen?
Ja, so as ons aan die woestijn kyk, daar val nie reën nie. En dit is die simboliek van hierdie wêreld. En het jy self so baie daarin gedink dat, want ek bedoel, dit is maar een groot prediking wat ons mee groot geword het. Ek onthou, dit is die eerste ding wat ek gehoor het, toe ek tot wedergeboorte gekom het en ek was in die kerk. Het ek gehoor van hierdie groot herlewing wat gaan plaasvind. So dan gaan elke een die gees van die Here ontvang, dit gaan hierdie massiewe besigheid wees, elkeen gaan dit instant verander en daarna gaan dit die wederkoms wees. Het jy al daarin gedink, het jy al vir jouself so gesê, wag jy ook al dalk daarvoor? Baie mense wag daarvoor, as 'n teken.
Yes, and now we can see that the ministry of the two witnesses will be until the end. Okay, so according to what we see here, can we really say there is going to be this mighty revival that are prophesied and preached in the world? Because there will be no rain.
Wow. Ja, sê hierdie twee getuienisse bedien in die eindtyd, in die laaste dae.
Yes.
So sal daar dan, as ons nou kyk na hierdie reën, sal daar dan hierdie herlewing wat almal verwag plaasvind? Terwyl hulle bedien, terwyl die woord sê, daar gaan geen reën wees nie.
Yes, amen. Het is al een bietjie kommentaar.
Okay. Kitty sê, ek het dit altyd gedink, maar weet nou, dat herlewing in ons harte moet plaasvind. Elmarie sê, revival begins in your heart. En iemand het nog iets gesê.
Nee, ek sê, mense gaan so op en af die hele tyd.
Mense denk, hulle is bezig met die gees, die getuienisse gaan wys, dat die gees een verkeerde gees is. Is dit iets wat nog moet gebeur?
Yes.
Dink bietjie.
Okay, well, let us read here in John 4. John 4. If you think of a desert, and God sent Abraham to Canaan, it was also a desert place. And in the Middle Eastern countries, even those years, their main source of water was underground, isn't it so?
Yeah.
That's why Abraham dug wells, so that he could have water to feed his flock. Because it's a dry, arid place.
Wow.
So all the water are underneath. It's not on top.
Wow.
If you want to live in a desert, you must find water underneath the ground. Isn't it so?
Yes.
That's the source of water.
Ja, so in die woestijn is die water altyd ondergronds. So as jy in die woestijn wil lewe, moet jy die water ondergronds kry. Dit is nie boogronds nie.
Yes.
En nou as jy self dink aan die wêreld,
yes.
Dan kan jou hartjie so 'n bietjie verder gaan en ek dink ons hartjies klop volgens ons so vinnig.
Okay, but let us read here in John 4. John 4 verses 13 and 14. This is the instance where Jesus Christ were at the woman of Samaria, at the well of Samaria, and they had a conversation, and eventually Jesus Christ said to ask her to give him a drink, and so on. And so that was the conversation. We all know about this situation. But I just want to read verse 13 and 14, what was Jesus Christ's reply to this woman? Jesus answered and said to her, "Whoever drinks of this water will thirst again. But whoever drinks of the water that I shall give him will never thirst, but the water that I shall give him will become in him a fountain of water springing up into everlasting life."
Wow.
So the water, if you accept the Lord Jesus Christ, the water comes from within. And if you look underground, you don't see anything underground. We don't see the heavenlies. We don't see God's kingdom with this physical eyes.
Yes.
But that must be our source of water that we draw from. And Jesus Christ says, if we draw from him, from the heavenly, because there's the stream of life, the river of life. If we draw from that on earth, we will realize and understand and experience this water like a well, because a fountain, the water is underneath the ground.
Yes.
And when you open it up, the water comes out of the ground. And our heart are like that. Our heart are in the secret place. Jesus Christ says, seek your Father who is in the secret place, and he will reward you openly. So we must understand that the source of our water comes from the heavenlies when we open our heart.
Ja, so wanneer ons die Here Jesus Christus aanneem in die wedergeboorte, dan ontvang ons die water ondergronds. Het jy al ooit daaraan gedink? Die water kom nie van bo af nie. So dit is nie iets wat op jou val en uitgestort word op sekere tye terwyl jy nie die Here dien en sulke dinge nie. Dit is in jou hart ontvang jy hierdie water. So dit breek deur hier van jou binneste af. So yes. Jy gaan nie buite iets ontvang nie.
Yes.
Jy moet binne, in jou siel, in jou innerlike, in die hemele, moet jy iets ontvang. En die bron van die water wat ons moet ontvang, is in die hemele. Dit sê so mooi, die woord sê, dit vloei uit die troon van God uit.
Yes.
So as jy nie jou hart oopbreek en indelf, en die water gaan kry in die hemele, in jou siel, in jou hart nie, gaan jy dor en droog wees. As jy wil wag en kyk vir water wat van bo af gaan kom, van 'n herlewing wat van bo af gaan kom, gaan jy vir altyd wag. Maar as jy kan besef, ek moet die Here so dien, ek moet hom so soek, ek moet my wortels laat diep ingaan na die ondergrondse water wat niemand sien nie, want die water wat daar is, wat ons moet kry, kan niemand sien nie. Daar is nie bewys daarvan nie, dis in geloof wat ons deel raak van dit.
Yes,
so ek dink ons kan nou klaar mooi verstaan, want dit gaan nie oor sondaars nie, dit gaan oor niks anders nie. Dit gaan daaroor, daar gaan nie reën wees nie. Maar die water is ondergronds. En ons as kinders moet dit daar, van die Here moet dit daar gaan kry. Nou, ons gaan so 'n bietjie gesels hoe jy dit daar gaan kry.
Ja, nou Jesus Christ, he ministered the gospel and says, if you believe in me, in other words, if you open your heart, you must open your heart. It's not something that God's going to force on anybody. We must open our heart. And when we open our heart and we accept the Son of God, when we become born again, we break open this earth symbolically. And then it is a fountain of water flowing from our heart that are in the secret. Because the rivers, and we see in this world, the rivers underground are unseen. You cannot prove it. And that is what the Bible says. This is the real faith. Faith is the evidence of the things you cannot see.
Yes.
You cannot see where your heart is. You cannot see where Jesus Christ is. You cannot see where God is. I cannot prove to you the living waters flowing from the throne of God. But I can accept it in faith. And when I really accept it in faith and I open my heart towards it, then I experience that joy and that gladness flowing from the throne of God.
Wow.
But we close ourselves. We close the wells. We open at our spiritual rebirth. And as we are walking the road, we close that wells once again.
Yes.
Yes. The water is underneath. We wait for water that must come over us from some preaching or from somebody somewhere else. But our hearts are closed. We have closed our hearts. And we today, we must open our hearts so that the water that is underneath in the secret place, in the heavenlies, can break through in our life.
So, it's eigenlijk so warm to think that wat die woord daar sê van die twee getuienisse, terwyl hulle bedien, gaan daar nie reën wees nie. So dit gaan, niemand gaan enige lewe of enigiets ervaar in sy binneste, as hy nie die woord van die Here aanvaar, die wedergeboorte, die pad wat gestap moet word nie. Daar gaan iets van buite af op jou val en kom, waarvoor jy wag, jy gaan jare wag. Want dit wat hulle bedien is die woord van die Here. Dis die krag van verlossing, dis die krag van vrymaking. So jy moet jou hart oopbreek vir daai woord om jou hart te penetreer sodat daai strome van lewende water hier kan deurbreek uit jou binneste. So dit is iets wat in die verborgene is. Dis iets wat ons nie kan bewys nie. Yes. Maar wanneer jou hart oopbreek, wanneer jy die woord aanvaar en toepas, dan begin jy voel, maar hier kom daai vreugde, daai blydskap, daai heerlikheid begin so deur 'n mens breek en vloei. Dan weet jy, nou het ek daai strome van lewende water getref, want dit is wat my gaan voed. Dis wat my dors gaan les, dis wat my gaan versadig.
Yeah, it was quite amazing. We can read in 2 Kings as well, and as well is in Isaiah 37 verse 31. Isaiah 37 verse 31. The Lord talks about Judah here, and it is actually a prophetic word. He says, there will come a time that you will take root downward and bear fruit upward.
Oh.
Okay, you will take root downward and you will bear fruit upward. That is now in Isaiah 37 verses 31. That was a prophetic word over Judah because they left the Lord and they were disobedient, and this prophetic word at this stage came out. So where, if you must take root downward, it means the water is down. It's not up.
Yes.
You cannot expect rain from on top. Your root must go downward. It must go into the secret place.
Wow.
It must make the effort to get to that water, that stream of water that is in the unseen. And this is what Jesus Christ tried to tell this woman. If you open your heart, if you're going to start drinking of me, if you can open your life to me, then your roots are going downwards.
Wow.
It is going into the secret place. And then only, if you are fed from beneath, you can bear fruit in the open, in the outward.
Wow, that's so cool. Jesaja 37 vers 31. Dan sal die vrygeraaktes wat oorgebly het van die huis van Juda weer wortels skiet onder toe en vrugte dra boontoe.
Wow.
Dit is net so super cool en amazing. As 'n mens kan verstaan in jou geestelike lewe dat jy kan nie hier water probeer iewers opvang nie. Ek het eendag 'n boodskap bedien oor gebarste reënbakke.
Yes.
En dit het my so getref daai tyd in my hart dat baie keer hardloop ons met 'n reënbak en ons probeer iewers iets opvang, maar daai reënbakke is gebars, so die water gaan uitloop. Vir 'n oomblik kan jy dalk bietjie beter voel, jy kan dalk vir 'n oomblik bietjie versterk voel of wat ook al, maar dan loop daai water uit en is gone. Dan het jy weer niks en as jy weer so droog en dor soos wat jy was. Maar as 'n mens kan verstaan dat jy moet in jou geestelike lewe insit, jou wortel moet afgroei daar in die ondergrond, daar in die secret wat ons nie van weet of sien nie. Daai wortel moet by daai lewende water uitkom sodat dit gevoed kan word, sodat dit kan deel raak van jou lewe en kan uitspring. Dit is so mooi, daai sê dit kom uit, dit spring uit die ewige lewe uit.
Yes,
uit die ewigheid uit. So dit is net so mooi om daaraan te dink. Ons moet dit ontvang en deel raak van ons lewe sodat ons vrug kan begin dra. Want ons wil uit die vlees uit probeer vrug dra. Nou kan jy verstaan, as jy uit die vlees uit gaan probeer vrug dra, gaan dit baie vinnig verwelk. Jy gaan al vir 2 of 3 dae kan jy voel, nee, ek gaan nou hierdie beter persoon wees, ek gaan nou vriendelik probeer wees en ek gaan nou probeer dit en probeer dat. As dit nie van die binne af kom en jou wortel skiet in en dit kry bekom by hierdie lewende water uit nie, want die gees moet die vlees oorwin.
Yes.
So dan kan daai vrug na vore kom en dan kan jy begin vrug dra.
Yes,
boontoe, dat almal kan sien.
Because if we look at a fleshly gospel, it's all about outward appearance. So if we are trying to expect something in the outward appearance, we're going to miss the point. Now, Al Marie has asked, does it mean that nobody's going to get saved in this time? No, that doesn't mean that. Mm-hmm. They minister the gospel. And while they minister the word, it's like fire. And it says it will devour the enemies, the same as the Lord has said to Jeremiah, for your word will devour or consume your enemies. As the word are going out, it destroys the thoughts in a person's heart, their conviction. And if they repent, and if they understand, when they hear the gospel, as an individual, they understand my life is a mess. They understand they're going to hell. They feel guilty about this sin, and they repent, as it has been preached from the beginning. If they repent, in them, the water will flow out.
Yes.
But it's not a preaching. The preaching that are preach is that the Spirit just comes down and actually forces everybody to become children of God. The person who opens his heart, that water he will receive from within, from the secret place. Hallelujah. So it's not an outward thing, it's an inward thing.
Ja, so Almer die vraag, gaan niemand in daai tyd gered word waar die twee getuienisse die woord bedien nie. En dit is 'n awesome om aan te dink dat terwyl die woord van waarheid uitgaan, is daar mense wat die woord van waarheid aanneem en gered word en vrykom en loskom en verloskom. Maar ook terwyl die woord van waarheid bedien word, is daar ook mense wat dit verwerp.
Yes,
so dit is altyd hoe dit is. So en mense voel die wat nou nie die woord aanneem nie gaan op 'n stadium net eweskielik hierdie reën oor hulle kry. Hulle gaan geforseer word om die Here te dien en aan te neem en dan gaan alles net sharp en chanana wees. Nee. Wat gebeur is terwyl die woord van waarheid uitgaan, moet die individu wat dit aanhoor dit aanneem, sodat sy siel gered kan word en sodat hy kan deel word van hierdie lewende water van redding, verlossing, vrymaking, suiwering en al daai tipe van dinge. So ek dink as dit so kan verstaan, dan gaan dit vir ons 'n ding oopmaak vir oggend om te besef, Here, daar's mense wat die waarheid aanneem en daar's mense wat die waarheid verwerp.
Amen. And that is the big thing. God doesn't force himself on people. Even if we look at the outpouring of the Holy Spirit, everybody that was in the room, their hearts were open. Yeah. Those on the outside, their hearts wasn't open at that very moment. Yeah. That's why they didn't receive the Holy Spirit. Yeah. Okay? The persons whose hearts were open received it. And when Peter ministered, then a lot of and thousands of people's hearts became open. They opened their hearts. And so they received the repentance and were baptized, etc., and received the Holy Spirit. But in that, there is still tens of thousands that still didn't believe while they were in Jerusalem and saw everything.
Yeah.
So every individual must open his or her heart so that the waters from heaven can flow and break through in their hearts. Yeah. And we're going to read the scripture now as well in John, I see Rowena said yes, it makes her think of John 7 and we're going to read there as well.
So dit is 'n moment en ek dink die uitstorting van die Heilige Gees plaasgevind het. Die wat sy harte oop was en tot wedergeboorte gekom het, die Gees van die Here kon hulle vul, as
yes,
ek dit so kan stel. Hulle kon hulle harte oopmaak en so die woord van die Here kon met hulle werk en praat. Maar almal het dit nie ontvang nie. Daar was skares voor hulle wat dit nie ontvang het nie. So net die wat gaan wag het, net die wat gehoorsaam was, het dit ontvang. En wat het Petrus vir hulle gesê? Bekeer julle self sodat julle die Heilige Gees kan ontvang. So met jou wedergeboorte ontvang jy die Gees van die Here. Sonder die Gees van die Here gaan jy nooit die strome van water, van lewende water in jou binneste ervaar nie. Want is die Gees van die Here wat dit vir jou lewend maak, wat kragtig deur jou breek, wat die strome van lewende water is. So nou kan ons verstaan dat dit is iets wat van buite af kan kom nie. Dis iets wat jy moet aanneem.
Yes.
Dis wat jy moet deel maak van jou lewe. So as jy tot wedergeboorte gekom het en hierdie Gees van die Here word in jou uitgestort, dan ontvang jy daai Gees van lewende water, die strome van lewende water. Wow.
Yeah, no, we know that Jesus Christ said in Matthew 13 about the seed sown in different places. There are those people who has no root in himself. So if you have no root in yourself, and here he's talking about people that that have accepted the word in a joyful heart. When they heard the gospel, immediately they received the gospel. But there were no root. And when persecution, etc. came, they fell away immediately. There must be root. If there's no root, who is our foundation? It's the Lord Jesus Christ. It's the Word of God. It's in the secret. In other words, it's people, for some reason, I cannot tell you why it's like that, but there are people who has got no root in themselves. In other words, they don't make an effort to seek the water. They are born again, but there's no root going out to so that they can stay in the water at the rivers of life flowing from the throne of God.
Wow.
And if you have no root in yourself, you won't bear fruit in the open. And therefore, when persecution, etc. comes, you do fall away because there's no root. Because the root goes down to the water. And as it is going down to the water, that root is becoming stronger. And that sustains the tree. Even if the tree starts growing and the elements above shakes it, the root keeps that tree intact.
Wow. So ja, daar is mense wat tot wedergeboorte gekom het, wat gedoop is, wat nie wortel in hulle self het nie. As die vervolging en die drukking en die dinge kom, dan val hulle weg. Want daar is nie wortel nie. Daar was nie effort gewees na jou bekering en jou doop om werklik die woord van die Here aan te neem en te groei en standvastig te raak. Want onthou net, 'n wortel is standvastig.
Yes.
So nou moet jy leer om standvastig te raak. Daai worteltjie is eers klein. Maar soos jy daai effort insit en soos jy vashou en daai winde kom en die storms kom en jy is op hierdie fondament, Jesus Christus, vas en jy raak standvastig, dan kan hy wortel al hoe meer dieper en dieper en dieper groei en standvastig geraak en een groter wortel raak,
as ek een sterk
groot wortel kan raak, wat kan ingaan en tot by die lewende water uitkom, jou bron, jou lewe, jou krag, jou alles kan daarby uitkom. Maar omdat 'n mens lei is, omdat 'n mens gaan stilstaan by jou bekering en jou doop, is daar die wortel nie.
Yes.
Jy wil nie geleer word nie. Dis wat die woord volgens so mooi vir ons gesê het, gaan maak disippels. Doop hulle en leer hulle alles wat hulle moet doen. So baie keer is ons so traag om te leer. Die Bybelskool is daar, maar ek het nie tyd nie. Dit is daar, maar ek het nie tyd. Hierdie woord is daar om te lees, ek het nie tyd nie. Ek is nie lus nie. Dan kry jy nie daai standvastigheid, daai wortel in jouself nie. En wanneer die winde en die storms verbykom, gaan jy val. Jy gaan struikel, jy gaan dalk terugval. En dit is hoekom ons moet vashou en daai wortel in onsself begin kry, daai standvastigheid, daai effort insit. Elke dag van jou lewe, want net met effort gaan jy daai wortel kan sterk maak.
Yes, because we cannot stay with our, as we mentioned in the beginning, at your spiritual rebirth and your baptism. You must make an effort to start growing. And as you are making that effort, the roots are becoming stronger and stronger. And this is a big problem. And as we've said in the beginning, people are dull. They are too lazy to hear. They are lazy to make an effort. I'm too busy to do the Bible school. I'm too busy to pray. Yuck, I'm so busy. I cannot even show a reaction on the group when some brother or sister encourages me. I cannot. I'm so busy. I cannot do this. You have no root in yourself. You have no. We make no effort to go down and make sure and feed from the word that are in the secret. Hallelujah. We must do it in faith. And we must go down and make sure that our roots are at the waters of life.
Sure.
Praise the Lord. Now let us read here in John 7, verse 37 till verse 39. On the last day, that great day of the feast, Jesus stood and cried out, saying, "If anyone thirsts, let him come to me and drink. He who believes in me, as the scriptures has said, out of his heart will flow rivers of living water." But he spoke concerning the Spirit whom those believing in him would receive, for the Holy Spirit was not yet given because Jesus was not yet glorified. And how did the people receive the Spirit? What did Peter say? Repent. Be baptized, you, and then you will receive the Holy Spirit. You don't sit back and you just receive the Holy Spirit. Peter said, repent, and then only you will receive the Holy Spirit. Yeah. And this is what Jesus Christ said. If you thirst, if you have a desire, if you know there's a problem in your life, we are in this desert world. And when we are in this desert world, we do thirst because there's no water.
Yeah.
But when you thirst, we long for water. And then the Lord Jesus Christ, hallelujah, the Father draws you to the Lord Jesus Christ. You start feeling guilty about your life. You know if you're going to die now, you're going to heaven. To hell. And if you repent, then only you will receive the Holy Spirit. Yes, so to answer the question further of Ellen Marie, the person who repents on the preaching of the word will receive the Holy Spirit if they open their heart to the word of God, the Lord Jesus Christ.
Johannes 7 vers 37 tot 39. En op die laaste dag, die dag van die fees, het Jesus gestaan en uitgeroep en gesê, as iemand dors het, laat hom na my toe kom en drink. Wat het hy gesê? As die wêreld is droog, die wêreld is dor,
yes.
Jy kry 'n begeerte, jy verstaan, my lewe is 'n gemors, dis droog, dis dor, daar beteken niks nie. En jy begin hierdie begeerte kry, om hierdie water in die hande te kry, om lewe in die hande te kry, dan moet jy jou hart oopmaak en die Here Jesus Christus aanneem in die wedergeboorte, want dis al waar jy daai water gaan ontvang wat jou dors kan les.
Yes.
Op hierdie aarde kan niks jou geestelike dors les.
Amen.
Hy sê, en hy wat in my glo, soos die skrif sê, neem my aan in die wedergeboorte, anders gaan jy nie in die koninkryk van God kan ingaan, en jy moet het glo soos die skrif dit sê, so neem my aan, en dan sal daai strome van lewende water uit jou binneste uitvloei.
Yes.
Hy sê, en hy het dit gesê van die gees wat die sou ontvang, wat in hom glo, want die Heilige Gees was daar nog nie, omdat Jesus nog nie verheerlik was nie. So Jesus het vir hulle gesê, dit gaan kom, wanneer ek gekruisig en opgestaan het uit die dode, gaan die Gees van die Here oor julle kom, in julle harte uitgestort word, wanneer julle my aanneem, dan is daar 'n tyd, wat daai dors geles kan word, in julle binneste. Maar is nie iets wat van boaf gaan kom en net op julle gaan val nie.
Jy moet jouself bekeer.
Jy moet jouself bekeer. Jy moet jou hart oopmaak. Jy moet die Here Jesus Christus in jou lewe innooi, sodat dit met jou kan gebeur.
Ja, and excuses, etc., spiritual laziness, dullness of hearing, close up that well again.
Yes.
And then you wonder, where is the water? Then we follow a gospel that promises us that the rain will once again come upon you. No, it won't. You must repent once again, open it well in your heart, so that the living waters can start flowing once again. Isn't that amazing?
Ja, want die sorge van die lewe en al die dinge maak dat die fontein wat jy ontvang het met jou wedergeboorte toegemaak word.
Yes.
En jy moet dit weer oopmaak. Jy moet jouself weer bekeer daagliks. Jou lewe uitsorteer, so dat die fontein kan oorbly, so dat dit nie toegedruk word en toegestop word nie, dat daai ding wat in die pad staan kan uitkom, so dat daai strome kan deurbreek in jou lewe. Want ons as kinders van die Here is baie keer soos depressiewe mense. Hoekom? Omdat ons daai fontein dooddruk.
Yes.
Omdat ons dit toemaak met sorge en omdat ons nie meer ons sonde bely nie, omdat ons nie sleg voel oor dinge nie, omdat ons net aangaan in ons lewe nie die woord lees nie, nie toepas nie, dan begin ons voel maar iets begin my druk. En dit is hoekom mense voel. Maar as jy jou lewe in besit neem en die Here begin dien in gees en waarheid en lewe, dan voel jy daai strome begin deurbreek en dan is daai heerlikheid en blydskap daar ongeag van jou omstandighede.
Yes,
want ons wil altyd hê die omstandighede moet ons opgewonde en bly en lekker laat voel en wat. Die omstandighede gaan vir jou niks doen nie. Maar die strome van lewende water uit die hemele uit, dit moet jou siel verkwik.
Yes, and what is amazing, when we read in Genesis, we once ministered about this as well. Genesis 49 from verse 22, it's a prophetic word about Joseph. Genesis 49 from verse 22, and it's actually, if you read through it, we know it's a prophetic word about Jesus, and all those that believe in the Lord Jesus Christ will experience the same. He says, Joseph is a fruitful bough by a well. His branches run over the wall. The archers have bitterly grieved him, shot at him and hated him. But his bow remained in strength, and his arm and the arms of his hands were made strong by the hands of the mighty God of Jacob. From there is the shepherd, the stone of Israel. So here we can see that Joseph, this prophetic word, is all about Jesus Christ. He is this fruitful bow, this tree that are at the well. So where there's a well, there's water underneath the ground. It's in the secret place. And that is, Jesus Christ says, I came to do the will of my Father. Everything that I've done is from my Father who is in the secret. And he had persecution as well. And we will have persecution as well. But if our roots are well grounded, underground, steadfast, like the Lord Jesus Christ, like the example that he set for us, then your branches will grow over the tree so that other peoples can also receive from your fruit.
Wow, is dit nie mooi nie? Genesis 49 vers 22. Joseph is a jong vrugteboom, a jong vrugteboom by die fontein. Sy takke klim oor die muur. Is dit nie mooi nie? So, hy was in hierdie fontein ingewortel. Yes. En daarom kon sy takke oor hierdie muur klim en sy vrug kon oor hierdie muur klim, so dat almal dit kon sien. Hy sê die boogskutters het hom wel geprikkel en hom beskiet en hom bestry. Nou, hier sit 'n profetiese woord oor die Here Jesus Christus. Maar sy boog het sterk gebly en die arms van sy hande was buigsaam deur die hande van die magtige van Jakob, daarvandaan waar die herder die steen van Israel is. So as ons in die Here Jesus Christus bly, as ons wortels in daai fontein laat ingroei, dan sal dit sal die vrug na boontoe laat uitsprei. Yes. Dit sal maak dat hierdie boom sy takke, oral waar jy kyk, sal hierdie boom se takke wees met vrug, met lewe, sodat jy ook vir ander kan uitdeel. Maar jy kan nie dit van buite af probeer kry nie.
Yes,
dis van ondergronds af. En
yes,
die Here het so mooi met my en Stanley gepraat toe ons so kort getroud is in Swaan en ons moes hierdie pad begin stap om al hierdie dinge te kon begin verstaan. Hierdie Here het ons gesê dat hy gaan ons toelaat vir 'n tyd om te groei. En dan gaan hy ons afkap. En dan gaan hy vir ons 'n tyd gee om te groei. En dan gaan hy ons afkap. Want wat gebeur as jy afgekap word? Jou wortelstelsel raak sterker. Dit groei verder. So baie min het, of mense het min bo gesien in ons lewe. Wat gebeur?
Yes.
Maar in daai tyd wat die Here ons so afgekap het en deur baie dinge gevat het, het daai wortelstelsel het hy ingegaan en ingegaan en sterker geword, sodat ons kon verstaan ons moet by die lewende water uitkom.
Ja.
Al was daar nog niks bo nie. Al het mense gesien, daar kom hulle 'n bietjie uit, joep, wortel afgekap. En mense het moedeloos geraak met ons lewe. En hoekom dit so gaan? Maar ons het besef dat die Here vat daai wortels diep in, sodat ons vandag kan verstaan waaroor die woord van die Here gaan en dit aan u bedien.
Yes,
dit kan getuig van die waarheid van die woord aan u, sodat u ook kan loskom en vrykom en kan verstaan. Kry standvastigheid, kry onbeweeglikheid, maak nie saak van jou omstandighede wat om jou is, maak nie saak of jy voel jy word die heeltyd afgekap nie. Gaan aan, soek, delf in, dien die Here met alles wat jy het, sodat daai wortelstelsel kan diep ingaan.
Now my wife and myself, we received the prophetic word in the beginning of our marriage that the Lord will permit us to grow for a while, then he will cut us off completely. Then we will grow, then he will cut off us completely, so that our root can penetrate and can become strong, so that it can penetrate down to the living water, so that what it doesn't matter what happens on top, in the visible,
yes,
that we can be steadfast and still draw our spiritual strength from the word of God. Hallelujah.
Yeah.
And obviously, if it's the word of truth, the Holy Spirit confirms the word. That's why I say you will receive the Holy Spirit, because you must receive the word of truth, and the word of truth gets confirmed and empowered by the Holy Spirit, and the Holy Spirit is also fire, and therefore the word of truth is like fire out of your mouth.
Amen. Wow.
Yes, praise amen. Hallelujah.
Yeah.
Otherwise, it's words of emptiness. Now, let us read a scripture here in 2 Peter 2 from verse 17 and 18. And this is what the Lord wants to impress us on today. We must start to understand something. It's not about the change of your circumstances. When you are in things, in your daily life and grind, you must keep on seeking the Lord. Not just waiting for the outcome of your situation. Seek the Lord. Try to understand what the Word of God are telling you in your spiritual life. Acknowledge where things come to the fore that is wrong. If you understand you've got a wrong character, if you understand you have got still sinful ways, repent from it.
Amen.
Go into the Word and seek answers and deliverance in the Word of God. And this is what we did. When we were in a specific situation and we were there, and the moment when we realized what is going on here, we went to the Scripture, we seek the Lord for answers. We didn't put on YouTube and Google and start listening to millions of people's opinions. We went back to the to the Bible. Praise the Lord. Those years there were no Google and YouTube and whatever. So we went back to the Word of God. And that is our root. Therefore, we can minister in surety without the fear that I'm going to blaspheme against somebody or something. Because I know what is the root. I know where is the origin of things in God's Word.
Ja, want ons besef dat mense kyk na hulle omstandighede. En mense wil hulle omstandighede uitgesorteer. Ons kry baie WhatsApps. En dit het my vanoggend weer baie hart en my diep in my hart getref. Dat ek het gister weer 'n WhatsApp ontvang. Bid asseblief vir my omstandighede. En ek sê vanoggend vir my man, wie stuur 'n WhatsApp en sê, bid vir my siel. Bid vir my innerlike, so dat ek hemel toe kan gaan. En in ons omstandighede, het ek en Stanley besef, ons kan net terug gaan na die woord toe. Ons kan nêrens, ergens heen gaan, behalwe terug na die woord toe. En elke keer, in alles wat ons deurgegaan het, het ons besef, ons moet die Here bly dien. Dit help nie nou om die Here te los nie. En jy moet jou antwoorde in die woord van die Here gaan soek. Want jy kan nie nou die Here, jy moet die Here bly dien. En ek wil gaga's net so vinnig getuig en ek wil hê moet dit vas soos wat ek dit sê vanoggend, want dit is die opgewondenheid in ons harte vanoggend. Dit is so 'n blydskap en 'n heerlikheid. Dis kom sê hierdie tyd was vir ons die awesomeste tyd van ons hele lewe. Ons het dinsdag aand het ons gepak om hierdie roadtrip te begin. En weet jy wat? Ons het nie petrol geld gehad om hierdie roadtrip te begin nie. En ons het daai aand terwyl ons pak, toe kom daar 'n inbetaling deur van R1000. Dis wat ons gehad het. En ons besef maar dis ons eerste tank petrol. En ons gooi daai tank petrol in en ons weet nie hoe gaan ons verder nie, maar ons weet daai tank petrol gaan ons tot in Beaufort West bring. En ons is in Beaufort West. En die Here werk en hy praat en hy deel en is so awesome en is antwoorde en is 'n heerlikheid en is wysheid en is insig oral waar ons. En ons besef, Here, maar ons kan nie môre hier ry nie. Ons kan nie verder gaan nie. Ons het nie geld of petrol nie. En dit is so opgewondenheid in ons harte. En die volgende oggend nou sit ons sit hulle maar aan tafel en ons kuier saam met Fransie en Kathleen, wat ons kan nie ry nie. En ons het so kwart tank petrol oor en ons staan op 'n stadium op en ons dog toe elke ons moet seker maar pad vat. Ons het nou alles gepraat, die Here het mooi gewerk, die Here het antwoorde gegee, alles. En toe ons kar toe gaan, toe voorsien die Here die volgende tank petrol. En dis wat ons het. En ons gooi daai tank petrol in. En ons kom nader en nader en nader aan Kwalsberg. En ons besef, maar ons moet petrol ingooi. En ons het hierdie padwerke en ons het hierdie stop and go's en al hierdie dinge, so dit vreet jou petrol. En toe ons net so voor ons in Kwalsberg ingaan, toe kom daar 'n betaling deur vir petrol in Kwalsberg. En ek kan vir sê, ons trip het letterlik van dorp na dorp gegaan.
Yes.
So wat wil ek vanoggend vir sê? Moet ons in ons omstandighede vaskyk? Moet ons kyk wat ons het en nie het om die werk van die Here te doen nie?
Yes.
Nee, gaan in gehoorsaamheid. Doen die werk van die Here. Die Here sal met jou saamwerk. Dit wat jy moet doen, dit wat jy moet hê, dit wat jy moet uitsorteer, sal die Here voorsien as jy sy werk doen. Maar ons wil baie keer gerief hê. Ons wil baie keer hê die Here moet voorsien sodat ons gerief in ons eie lewe kan hê. En dit is wanneer daai wortel 'n probleemstelsel begin raak.
Yes.
Gaan af, gaan soek, gaan begin die woord van die Here verkondig, begin die Here soek, begin geleer word, so dat jy kan gaan leer, so dat hy wortelstelsel uitgesorteer kan word, en so kan die Here vir 'n mens deurbreek, en jou geestelike lewe uitsorteer, dan is hy wortel vast, maak nie saak, wat jy sien nie voor nie, jy gaan.
I think we have a big misconception about the Bible, faith, etc. in the Word of God. The entire Bible, when the Bible talks about faith and not becoming despondent and not becoming worried, etc., it's all about the gospel,
Amen.
The preaching, the ministering of the gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ. We use scriptures to gain material wealth, to use them so that we gain material wealth. And then we spend our life and material things on greediness. Let us be honest with this. On greediness and pleasures of the world. Then we get in trouble. And then we say, no, the Lord says I must just have faith. Me and my house, we will serve the Lord. But we don't serve the Lord. We don't even go to the effort even to pray about our circumstances. So it's all about God provides, and we must not lose faith.
Amen.
While preaching the gospel, ministering the gospel, getting knowledge about the gospel, make sure that my doctrine that I believe in my heart is correct. That is faith. That is not becoming despondent. That is not becoming disheartened. And we bring things on ourselves because we are greedy. Let's be honest today.
Ja, want die Here voorsien ons behoeftes.
Yes.
En baie keer wil ons ons begeerte ook vervul hê. En dis waar ons seer kry. Dit is waar ons wegtrek en daai wortelstelsel kry skade. Want mense voel, Here, U is nou nie saam met my as ek nie sekerheid het nie. En ek en my man sê vir mekaar terwyl ons in die kar ry, dat met baie keer wanneer jy die werk van die Here wil gaan doen, wil jy voel jy het sekerheid. Ek het 'n sekere bedrag geld in die bank en met daai sekerheid kan ek nou gaan en ek kan my ding gaan doen. Maar dit is wat die Here nie toelaat in ons lewe nie. Dis altyd daai onsekerheid, want jy moet in geloof moet jy gaan.
Yes.
Jy moet die Here vertrou omdat jy die werk van die Here gaan doen. En dis waar ons seer kry en dit is waar ons gaan terugsit wanneer ons begeerte nie vervul word nie. Die Here ken jou behoefte. Hy ken jou tankpetrol, hy ken jou broodjie langs die pad. Maar ons soek meer. Ons wil meer in ons vlees wil ons voel, Here, ons is seker, ons weet presies wat in ons lewe aangaan en gebeur. En dan voel dit asof die Here vir ons guns gee.
Yeah, and as we are living out our pleasures and desires and greed in the world, we come into financial material troubles, and then we cannot support the word of the ministering of the word. We cannot support the spreading of the word of God because we got ourselves into a circumstances.
That's right.
And that is also a big thing. Now, when we look here in 2 Peter 2 from verse 15, 2 Peter 2 from verse 15, here the context is those that has forsaken the right way and gone astray. Has forsaken the right way. So here he's talking to children of God who has forsaken the right way. Okay? They still have this outward appearance, I'm a child of God, I'm a Christian, etc. Then he says, they have forsaken the right way and gone astray, following the way of Balaam, the son of Beor, who loved the wages of unrighteousness, but was rebuked for his iniquity. A dumb donkey speaking with a man's voice, restraining the madness of the prophet. But from verse 17 and 18 is quite amazing. These are wells without water, clouds. That's this clouds is this mist clouds, eh? Mist clouds carried by a tempest, for whom is reserved the blackness of darkness forever. For when they speak great swelling words of emptiness, they allure through the lusts of the flesh, through the lewdness, the ones who have actually escaped from those who lived in error. While they promise them liberty, they themselves are slaves of corruption, for by whom a person is overcome by... Okay, I'm going to read further. Now, he says here, there are wells. There's a well, but in that well, there's no water. So when they speak words of emptiness. Oh. And the only words they can speak is the lust of the flesh. They minister a gospel that soothes the ear. It ministers a gospel that tells us that it's all about this world. It's the lust of the flesh. Then that is a gospel that has forsaken the truth.
Ja.
And we must make sure that there is water in our well.
Hmm.
And we must return to the one who really gives that life-giving water.
Ja, 2 Petrus 2 vers 17. Hulle het die regte pad verlaat en verdwaal en die weggevolg van Bileam, die seun van Beor, wat die loon van ongeregtigheid liefgehad het, maar die bestraffing van sy eie oortreding ontvang het, die stom laster het met die stem van 'n mens gepraat en die waansinnigheid van die profeet verhinder. Hulle, en dit het ons gevang hierdie skrip, hulle is waterlose fonteine, miswolke, voortgedrywe deur 'n stormwind, vir wie die donkerheid van die duisternis vir ewig bewaar word. So, baie keer is mense besig met 'n evangelie, van Bileam, van ongeregtigheid, van welis, van hebsig, en al die type van dinge. En wat maak dit? Dit maak dat jy 'n waterlose fontein is. Jy leer mense, maar jy leer mense leefwoorde. Die woord van die Here sê, hulle is altyd besig om te leer, maar hulle kom nooit tot die kennis van die waarheid nie. So jy is hierdie leefontein wat probeer ander leer, maar daar is niks in jou nie, daar is geen water nie, jy is droog, jy is dor. En hy sê, dit is soos die stormwind, wat die wolke voordryf in donkerheid. So, hulle wag vir iets, maar daar is niks. Hulle wag vir reën, maar daar's niks. Want waar moet daai water vandaan kom? Dit moet jou wortel wees wat afgroei, wat besef het, dit gaan nie oor my omstandighede nie, dit gaan nie oor of ek het en of ek nie het nie. Ek moet die werk van die Here doen. Ek moet afgroei, ek moet volwasse raak, ek moet seker raak, ek moet leer, ek moet standvastig raak sodat ek ander kan leer, sodat as ek my mond oop maak, dat dit nie 'n waterlose fontein is nie, dat hier nie allerlei nonsens uit my mond uitkom nie, maar dat dit ware woorde van lewe en krag en verlossing en vrymaking is, wat uit my mond uitkom, want daai strome van lewende water moet die vrug wees na ander toe, wat ander ook voed en vrymaak en verlos, beloof die Here.
Yeah, if our well is dry, this is what it says, it's clouds, it's mist clouds, there's no rain in them, the wind is just blowing them away. And if there's no water in our well, this is when we expect something from the outward. This is when we expect that our circumstances might change. And if our circumstances change for the better, we are at ease and think, oh, the Lord has answered me. But what did your circumstances advance in the gospel? What is something that we received from the Word of God so that we can advance the gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ? That this is the beginning and the end of the message of the Bible, is the advancement of the gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ, and live a holy life, strive for that holiness so that we can enter into the kingdom of God. And if you are sitting in a situation, you are in this dire straits, I want to encourage you today.
Amen.
Doesn't matter what your circumstances is today, start reading the Bible.
Amen.
Don't worry about seeking verses to encourage you. Start reading the Bible with all diligence, prayerfully. Start talking to the Lord about what you are reading. Say, Lord, I'm reading now in 2 Peter 1 verses 21. And it's amazing, what a privilege to read the Bible, because it is a hidden treasure.
Yeah.
We don't realize. They asked Jesus Christ, are those who are those that are saved few? He says, yes, it's few. You must strive hard to go in there.
Yeah.
And then the Lord Jesus Christ also spoke a parable in Matthew 13 verses 44 about this man who came about in a field, who found this treasure. And we don't realize what treasure we do have. The moment when God reached out to you with your spiritual rebirth, we don't realize the treasure that we have. It's so rare. We have a rare treasure. Only a few find it. And what do we do with that very rare treasure? Can we grasp it this morning?
Wow.
We have a very, very rare treasure, and you have it. If you are listening to the message today, you are listening to something that are extremely rare, and you can only find it in the secret place.
Wow.
And this man went out and he sold everything to buy that field so that he can have that treasure.
Wow.
The word of God is a treasure. It is a rare commodity. We think other things are rare, but the gospel is the rarest thing that you can ever find.
Wow.
And we must cherish that with our life. We must sell everything. We must get rid of our mindset, of our own ideas, of our own correct character, so that we can get the knowledge and the idea and the will from this treasure and live our life according to that.
Ja, so as ons hierdie skat ontvang het van die evangelie van waarheid, het ons 'n rare skat ontvang.
Yes.
En dit moet ons bewaar met ons hele lewe. Ek kan net dink as ek iewers 'n verskriklike groot diamant moet kry en dit is hierdie waardevolle skat. Hoe ek dit gaan bewaar met my lewe. Ek gaan nie slaap nie. Ek gaan die hele tyd met daai skatte besig wees. En dit is wat ons in die evangelie ontvang. En tog verwaarloos ons daai skat. Tog doen ons nie wat die woord van ons verwag om daai skat te bewaar nie. En die woord praat volgens so mooi met ons dat terwyl jy dit ontvang het, want is min wat dit vind. Dis min wat dit kry. Dis min wat hierdie woord van waarheid aanneem wat getuig word. En wanneer jy vandag hierdie woord hoor, dis 'n skat, dis 'n waarheid, dit is iets wat jy nêrens elders gaan kry nie. Dit gee vir jou die ewige lewe. Moet jy dit so bewaar, jy moet dit so koester met jou hele lewe dat jy bereid is om enige iets prys te gee. Sodat jy hierdie waardevolle rare skat kan bewaar vir die ewige lewe. Is dit nie amazing om vanaand te dink nie? Want ons kry iets. Ons kry die waarheid, dit word weer vir ons uitgelig, dit word weer vir ons aan die lig gebring. En dis 'n skat wat ons ontvang. En elkeen vanoggend moet ons weet, Here, ek moet daai skat in my hart bewaar. Ek moet alles prys gee. Ek moet niks bo daai skat ag nie. Vandag gaan ek daai skat verloor. Nou as ek net dink as ons iets hier op aarde moes kry wat van ons baie geld kon beteken, jy sal dit bewaar met jou hele lewe. Jy sal uit jou pad uitgaan. Jy sal mense uit die pad uitdruk om daai skat te bewaar. Maar in ons ewige lewe verstaan ons nie wat 'n skat dit is nie. So die Here praat volgens met ons.
Yes.
Ons moet ons harte oopmaak. Maak nie saak van wat hier gebeur nie. Vat hierdie skat wat jy ontvang het, hierdie woord van waarheid. Dit wat getuig word. Dit wat jy onder in die aarde en die ewige moet gaan kry waar dit nie sigbaar is nie. Bewaar dit.
Yes.
Met jou hele lewe.
How precious is the word of God for us. We can easily say, yes, I serve the Lord and I love the Lord, but what is our actions? Do we still have a mindset, a certain mindset, excuses not to protect this precious gem, this precious treasure that we received? We won't lay a precious thing just outside it for everybody to take hold of it. We will protect something in the physical. I mean, people get security companies, they get dogs, they get electric fencing, they do everything to protect their home because there's valuable things in that home. But what do we do with our gospel? We just let it go. We are too busy. That is the biggest excuse. I am busy. Busy with what? What is the treasure? There where your heart treasure is, there your heart is as well. And the Lord wants to encourage us today. We must get our root down to the true Word of God and make all effort to get to it and to maintain it and to keep it. So praise the Lord. Hallelujah.
Sure. Dit ben allemaal so hard te gepraat volgende en ek denk so my weer in my eie hart ook.
Yes, amen.
Dat ek sal nie te besig wees om my ding te bewaar op hierdie aarde nie. Maar baie keer is mense te besig om jou skat in die hemel te bewaar. En daar waar jou skat is, daar is jou hart. So as jou skat op hierdie aarde is, as jy hier besig is en hier die hele tyd wil wees, gaan jou skat hier wees. En jy gaan die ewige oordeel ontvang. Maar wanneer jou skat daar is in die hemele, waar jou hart is, wow, jou hart is waar jou skat is, dan het jy die ewige lewe, dan het daai wortel van jou diep ingegaan.
Yes, and start seeking the kingdom of God. Stop praying about just your circumstances.
Yes.
Start seeking. Just start reading the Bible We have a Bible school. If you have the Bible school, start diligently, learn it, make an effort, because there's a lot of treasures, a lot of amazing things in there, and that will open a lot of things in the Bible for you. And if you don't have the Bible school lessons, please contact us. We will email it to you so that you can also receive this amazing treasures that God has for us.
Ja, en as ons nie gaan bereid is om te leer, nie gaan ons nie groei nie.
Yes.
So jy gaan stil staan en jy gaan dink jy groei, jy gaan dink jy stap die pad. Maar oor 3 jaar is jy nog steeds precies dieselfde, jy het nog nergens heen gegaan of gegroei nie. Daar het nog nie een tak oor die muur geklim nie. So. Die wortel het nog nie ingegaan nie.
Ja.
En dis wat die Here vir ons sê, maak daai effort, al lyk dit vir jou hoe onsinnig, al lyk dit vir jou, niemand sien dit raak nie, niemand weet daarvan nie, dis waar die koninkryk van God gaan, dat niemand gaan jou ooit eer gee met dit wat jy mee besig is nie, in die woord van die Here nie. So dit is daar die verborgene, niemand gaan eens weet jy doen die Bybelskool nie, maar in dit gaan hy wortel diep in. Jy educate yourself, so dat jy kan groei, om vir ander ook vrug te dra.
If you have troubles on earth, start seeking the Lord, start reading the Bible. And if somebody tells you, aren't you going to do something about this? And now I'm busy with the Lord now. And he says he will help you in the things that must happen.
Praise die Here. Esmeralda, contact my asseblief. My nommerkie is op Facebook. Dit is daar by die comments. Michelle het dit opgesit. Stuur vir my 'n WhatsAppie en dan sal ons ook vir jou die Bybelskool aanstuur. Enige tyd, enige iemand wat wil deel raak hiervan, enige iemand wat dit wil ontvang, jy het net die Bybelskool handleiding nodig met jou Bybel, jy het geen ander bron van niks nodig nie. Al die skrifte is daar, alles is daar wat jy moet weet, wat jy moet leer, wat jy moet verstaan, so dat jy die Bybel beter kan verstaan. Prys die Here.
May you have a blessed day. Hallelujah. We are still here today in Northwest by Henry and Michelle. And tomorrow, if the Lord willing, we're going to Roland Rian here in Montana, Pretoria.
Yes, praise the Lord. See you tomorrow. Love you.
Bye. Bye-bye.